Thank you for Chairman. And I cannot, this time I cannot calculate the trend of calculator. So that's the calculator used in Japan and in 2010. Agri-food system program in Japan is a low food self-sufficiency. That is a very severe condition, but other industry get the money, so we can enough food. But self-staffing is also is a very important thing for us. So the need is sustainable intensification. Just you know. But at first, what we know is how much nutrient utilized and utilization is possible, and of course, how much nutrient resource we have is also important, because everything we import, every fertilizer resource was imported. So without current situation, we cannot plan anything. So we estimate nitrogen, phosphorus flow and cycle in Japan from statistics and national scale questionnaire as a potential as a portrait of agri-food system in 2010. Data source and calculation is here. Just a stationary calculation, point was set. I was more than 3,000 and fixed 5 years. Questionnaire was done for 5 years. In the questionnaire, crop yield and so on, and nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium come from Mishima et al. Method. Crop yield come from my first paper. And calculation is divided 4 farm folds, such as full time farm, part time farm, livestock farm, and crop farm. And 7 districts and 7 crop groups. Just as rice, apparent crop, vegetable, fruit, tea, fodder, forage. As a result, it was divided into about near to 200. Numerical average was of chemical nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium fertilizers, and cattle, swine, poultry manure was calculated in each sector, namely 200 each sectors. Then, area of each sector was estimated from agricultural census in 2010. This is a result case of phosphorus. Why phosphorus is a phosphorus is do not disappear during and composting. Namely, dung and urine was excreted and during composting, loss is very low. So I used one of the basement or tracer of material flow. The main input of phosphorus is a chemical fertilizer, but still an applied manure is a very small amount and no nutrient. Part is 3 times larger. I don't know, or probably no one knows. Not utilized compost is where it goes. But and the result of and it become a crop is a small, very small. As a result, huge amount of phosphorus is accumulate year by year. That is a very large problem in Japan. Case of nitrogen, most of nitrogen comes from also chemical fertilizer. And nitrogen use efficiency is near to 100%. Seems very high, but this was realized by a non-utilized part of composted manure. Total soil nitrogen was 24.3 kilograms in 1980. But 2000, only 20 years, the amount was greatly reduced. So is that okay or not is a very serious thing. So manure use will be also important to maintain soil nitrogen and promote the use of will realize reduction of chemical fertilizer. In conclusion, promotive use of manure is an important issue. If all manure is utilized, chemical phosphorus fertilizer use must be half of present situation. And the other half will be filled up by non-agricultural phosphorus source, such as recovered from municipal sewage, incinerated ash, phosphorus in steel making sludge, and so on. And stop total nitrogen decrease in farmland soil is also an important thing for us. And decrease in nitrogen hands, decrease phosphorus surplus will be by soil surface balance is also important for soil health and and increase nutrient use efficiency. For agricultural production system. That's all. Thank you very much. Kamsahamnida.
Thank you very much. This presentation is open for questions. And I have one. I'm a little bit surprised that you are now promoting to use more manure.
Yes.
I would think this is a big mistake because as long as we've been through that, we've been using manure and the green people said also you have to use manure, it's biological. But it destroys the environment, it eutrophies, you have leaching of nitrates and so on. So more and more we're repressing this and all manure more and more is to be processed first before you put it on the land. So now I hear here you say let's apply it just on the land. So
yes, of course. Of course, there are many, many parties. We divide seven areas, but one area has too much waste, agricultural livestock waste. In such case, not the application is not a perfect answer, but some part of it is incinerated, then just recover phosphorus. Or other place, use green manure if they do not enough soil, enough carbon source for maintain soil fertility. So there are many, many in the districts. I will calculate and making a scenario that is a future work for me. Is it all right?
Yeah, but should you be communicating more clearly that we don't want more unprocessed manure on the land? Because that's really a no-go in Flanders anymore and in Europe all the way. And now I hear here, put your manure on the land. It's sustainable. I don't think so anymore.
Yes, that may be a difference of culture. Because we do not use black water, sweet low switch, switch, municipal switch to agricultural field. That is relatively common in, that was relatively common in Europe. But in Japan, such a practice is not.
No, but no. It is the manure, not food. It is the manure that is the big problem. So I please ask you, I beg you, go to Europe and see what we are. Don't make the same mistake. I'm sorry, this was so long.
Sorry.
That's the issue.
What do you mean by process manure?
Well, manure that you then, where you separate the fractions and eventually you then get to produce more stable, cleaner products that you then can use as fertilizer. And the big bottleneck we have there is legislation. We can technologically do this, but we can't sell it as a fertilizer. It's because it's still falling, but that's a legislative problem. But there you certainly avoid all these problems of applying the direct manure on the land. So, this concludes this extremely interesting session. Thank you for all the speakers, and also thank you for the audience for actively participating. Let's have a big applause.